All right, here we go. That's a homemade redneck boiler. It's a 23-gallon air tank my boss gave to me, brand new, right off of someone who was going to throw it out, a brand new tank. So I got probably at least 12 or 13, 14 gallons in it. It's up to boil, and I'm getting about 40 pounds of pressure. I could probably open up the throttle. The throttle's fairly cracked. And I'm getting a little bit over 40 pounds of pressure. I gave you 41, 42. Leaking a little bit, but it seems to be holding up pretty well. I've run this engine at least 100 hours. And right now I got it hooked up to, that's a 44-tooth motorized bicycle sprocket. That's a 415 chain. Down to a 410 sprocket on a 24-volt brushless alternator. It's a permanent magnet alternator. And unfortunately, my volt meter ain't working. But according to that gauge, it's showing over 100 amps. I don't think I can trust this. It's a cheap-ass meter. I don't think I can trust it. But anyway, I think it's probably putting out at least a horsepower. Let's crack it open a little bit here. There we go. Now we're cooking. And I only had two cases. Let's hook up another case. If I can do it. There we go. I've got no clue how much power this thing's producing. Quite a bit, I reckon. Oh. Anyway, I'm real happy with it. Gonna adjust the timing a little bit. Keep an eye on it. I do not leave this unattended. You can see the tabletop flexing a little bit. And these are all O-ring. There's no metal to metal on it at all, other than the bearing. I probably need to re-engineer that post and all. You can see it flexing a little bit. But anyway, pretty happy with it. It's been pretty dependable. And the more I run it, the more I trust it. All right. Back up a little bit. One more shot. So, I don't know, when everyone else runs out of gasoline, I can still charge up my battery bank to run my shit. All right, hey, thanks for watching out there.